Hello students, welcome back once again. This is your English teacher Himanshi ma'am and we are doing the revision of chapter number 2 from your course books for class 8. That's right. Now students, in yesterday's video we have started the revision of chapter number 2. First part we have done where we have discussed the beginning of the story, and on basis of that I have given you a PDF from which you have to do the question answers, which are itself from your book. Right? And from yesterday onwards I see a lot of change in students' comments. Many students are now mentioning their name and section, which makes me really happy when I see it. But still there are some students who are not doing that. So this is again a reminder for all of you. Make sure whenever you are writing anything in the comment section, you are writing your name, class and section. And what are the three things that you have to do just right now? You have to like this video. Click on the like button quickly. I'll not go further. Yeah, that's right. And then share this video with your classmates. And make sure that more and more number of students from your circle, all those students with whom you are in contact, they have subscribed to the channel. I want to see the number of subscribers go really, really high. And with more and more videos. Now let's come to the revision part 2. We are doing chapter number 2, a lesson that lasted a lifetime. And this is a real life story told by Florence. Florence is a woman who was a little girl in the period of World War II, and she used to live in England with her family. She came from a poor middle class background. That's why she was facing a lot of economical problems, money related issues. And the biggest issue at that moment from which the story is written was that she was not able to get the full uniform. Her father was not able to purchase the blue blazer, which was part of her uniform, and because of which her strict headmistress in the girls' school was punishing her on daily basis in the morning assembly. Up till here we have discussed. Now let's come to a little change that happens in her life. The next part of the story tells us that something exciting, something different happened now in her life. What happened is her mother told her that her family had won a competition. There was a competition in the newspaper and they had participated and they got the first prize. And as a first prize, the entire family was going to get a free photographic portrait. Now students, when you're talking about the World War II period, that means we have to go in the time period between 1939 till 1945. That means many years ago. So all those times ago, we did not have so much of technology that we would just start taking selfies. It was the time when people would go to photographic studios and get their photos clicked by one single photographer. So that was a very expensive thing, and they got it as a first prize in the newspaper competition. She got very excited. Florence was really, really curious, excited and happy. She was imagining all sort of things. She was just a 12 years old girl. So, you know, this was a very big thing, a very different thing that was going to happen with her, because every day in school she was being mocked, she was being insulted on the basis of her dressing sense. And this was the first time that she had got the opportunity to dress up and go for a photograph, which was going to be free, right? So this was a really exciting point for her as well as her family. So in this excitement, she was thinking all sort of things. She was imagining herself that I'm some kind of heroine, I'm some kind of actress, I'll go for a photo shoot, I'll do modeling, I'll do this and that. I mean, she was just a 12-year-old girl. So this was a really exciting moment for her and as well as her family. So now her mother told her that, Florence, tomorrow when you go to school, don't wear the school uniform. Rather, wear that beautiful green dress that you have. Florence was having a green colored dress which was really beautiful. Her mother wanted her to wear that dress for the photograph. The mother told Florence that after school we will directly go to the studio for the photograph, so don't wear the uniform. Now suddenly all of the excitement changed into tension. All that amount of excitement and curiosity that Florence was filled in, it completely shifted into worries and tensions. She was completely shocked. She thought that in the school uniform, just for not wearing the blue blazer, her headmistress gives her punishment every morning in the assembly. And now when she will completely come in a different dress in the school, she will be in a lot of trouble. But as we had discussed earlier, she never shared her problems with anyone in the family. She never disclosed her punishments to her parents. So this time also she kept her mouth shut. She agreed with her mother and she went to school wearing that green dress. When she was going to school, there were so many things that were happening inside her. She was feeling all kinds of tension. She was like, today I will go, my headmistress will give me a lot of punishment. She will give me more punishment than every day. So she was going through all these things. Then when the time came for morning assembly, all the students were in the row, in their class rows. And today, you know what? Florence thought, it's better I do not wait for my headmistress to call out my name and then I will go on the stage to get my punishment. Today she decided that she will herself go. I mean, she was already feeling so insulted. She was lacking self-respect, lacking self-confidence. She was so underconfident about her personality, about her dressing, about her beauty. She was completely, you know, underconfident and having no respect for herself, which is very, very important, isn't it, student? Having self-confidence, having self-respect for your own being, it's very important, which she was lacking at that moment. So she decided that, okay, fine, I know my headmistress is going to call out my name and as usual I'm going to get punished on the stage, so it's better today I go myself. So she just gets up, she goes out of the row and goes on the stage and stands for punishment. Her headmistress looks at her that she's in the green dress. She gets completely shocked and then as usual she gets punishment. Here finally the punishment gets over. It is time for all the students to go back to class. Morning assembly is over. But again there's going to be a change in her life, and this change is going to be a positive kind of change. This part of the story we will discuss in the next video lesson. For now, this is enough. Today, once again, in the description box, you will find a link. From that, you will read in today's link. I have given you some fun facts, which I want you to read, learn and note down. After that, I've given you only one question today. It is again from your book. Okay, beta? I hope everyone is having the PDF of the chapter. When you will go in the PDF of the chapter number 2, you will come to the Let's Ponder section. Let's Ponder section part number 2 you will find out, and there you will see question number 1, which I want you to attempt from B part. Okay students, that's enough for today. Keep liking, sharing and subscribing. Keep doing your work and make sure you mention your name, class section whenever you are making any comment in the comment section. Bye bye, take care.